8 years, the images like the timeline seem both familiar but confusing. A civil war started in 2011 that soon became a regional conflict. A sort of geopolitical chess game, and watching it always.
And it's a country today that's under siege.
The CEO of Alight, formerly the American Refugee Committee, Daniel Wordsworth.
And you have these sort of external actors that are coming in the region to try to use Syria to destabilize that whole region. So it's a country that's really been in turmoil now for 8 years.
And given that turmoil, what is the refugee and the humanitarian situation like with regards to the people who were just trying to live their lives despite the war that was happening around them?
You have like 30 to 40% of the country that's being, you know, bombed, that's under attack, that's has been in war for all of these years.
It's those people, millions of refugees within and outside Syria, Alight has wanted to help every day of these 8 years. It's why Daniel welcomed the chance to travel to Damascus in December.
They're still trying to make a life. They're still walking the streets of Damascus. And so my experience of being there with them is getting to meet and spend time with people who are grappling with this sort of this challenge of making a life over so many years in a country that's so fragile.
A fragility Daniel described in a story about an unusual dinner request.
One night I had a chance to have dinner with a number of the team that work inside of Syria. And when I asked them what they wanted to have for dinner, they said they wanted ice cream. And then I thought, I suppose that's what happens when you live in war for 8 years. You decide, if I want ice cream tonight, I'm gonna have ice cream, yep? You're not sure what's gonna happen tomorrow.
But within the uncertainty, Alight has worked alongside its partner, Questscope. 4,000 volunteers and 1,000 staff offering the hands-on help Syrians have needed.
We're in any of the towns that you hear about, whether it's Damascus, Aleppo, Homs, Hama, these are the sort of infamous cities of Syria. You know, how do you break all of this down into like bite-sized pieces? So one of the ways we do that is we create these like community centers, and we have just under 100 of those. And we use those as kind of focal points to reach out into the whole community.
Centers where Alight and its partners offer food, classes to kids, job training to adults, and overall medical and mental health services.
Another thing that we've done is we've set up two factories. So we have one factory that actually produces jeans and makes clothing, and another one that makes bread.
And Alight helps find new homes in old buildings while also fixing and cleaning damaged water systems. All of that, an effort by Alight 8 years in the making, an effort that continues today and will still tomorrow.
I think one of the challenges in talking to people about Syria is the fact that it's gone for so long. And I think people now, they'd be tempted to like begin tuning out from this. 8 years seems like a long time. If you live in it, it seems like an eternity. But is that the length of our compassion? You know, these are still people. They're still grappling with these things every day. We're still there with them. And I suppose I would just ask people to let their compassion be like elastic and stretch long enough to go for 8 years and for people to still care about their country.
Daniel also says from Alight's perspective, life is getting better for the average Syrian in terms of just daily violence, but the need obviously continues. If this is something you're interested in supporting, we have information on our website for you to do just that.